Había una vez una princesita y ella era la princesita de las flores. Su mamá era la reina. Y su padre era un gran rey, el rey de todas partes. Y él sabía todo, todo. Era amable. A veces era feliz, pero otras veces era bien feroz. Solo Dios era más poderoso.
No seas tímida, hija. Saluda a tu padre.
Those are lovely flowers. Who are they for?
For you, Your Grace.
It's very kind. Do you know what they are?
Mistress Sarah says they're snowdrops.
Show me. No, my child. Snowdrops hang down. Their petals hang down like drops. Do you know what they are? Wax flowers. See? 5 petals. That means they're the wax flower.
Thank you.
La princesita era muy feliz porque su padre la amaba. Él estaba muy orgulloso de ella.
Prettier than you.
Prettier than you.
Prettier than me. Stronger than me.
Él la llamaba mi pedacito de Inglaterra y mi pedacito de España. Pero el rey estaba bravo, porque no tenía un hijo. Él dijo que una niña no era suficiente, que necesitaba un niño. Él dijo que era la culpa de la reina, pero no lo era. Entonces el rey encontró otra reina. Pero ella no era una reina de verdad. Era una reina mala. El rey quería casarse con la reina mala, pero el papá en Roma dijo que no. Y entonces el rey se puso bien bravo.
Seem to be a few problems here, Thomas. A few things I can't quite grasp. Here we have the Pope. He's saying how I can do this, and I can't do that. Who is the Pope?
He is the head of the church.
Is he the King of England?
La gente decía que el rey no estaba casado con la reina buena. Pero no era cierto. No era cierto.
Are you the Pope to judge in the matter? For one doctor who can say our marriage is void, I can give you a thousand that can say it is valid. Our marriage was made in heaven, and you will never destroy it.
I will have my wife! I will have my wife. I will have my wife.
La reina buena ya no era feliz. ¿Y la princesita? Tampoco fue feliz nunca más.
It was very confusing for us because we sort of felt it was like putting himself above God. How could he do that?
And of course, you know, thrown into all that meant you could, it meant that you could go into all the churches and monasteries and steal all the plate. Well, not steal. Well, it was steal, really. Yeah, it was.
I mean, that's a terrible thing to do, isn't it? You can't pull, change the church. That's how it's always been.
A lot of people disagreed with what he was doing, and they paid a heavy price. People like Bishop of Rochester, Fisher, his name, and Thomas More, of course, you know, he was famous. But there were a lot of other people who weren't quite so famous who paid the same price for disagreeing and or speaking out against what Henry was doing at that time. And it was not a happy time.
So much blood. Poor little Mary. Not so little now. Her father's divorce meant she was stripped of her title. No longer a princess, just Lady Mary, the king's daughter. That meant she was a bastard, basically.
She was a princess? I'm not going to be a bastard. How dare you call me a bastard? I'm a princess. I'll never accept that.
And she also didn't accept the new religion either. She was vehemently against it.
One church for her, one pure, holy Catholic church, forever and for always. A new church? Heresy. And Anne, she gave him a son, all right. A dead one.
Of course, there were rumours about what she'd been getting up to. You know, affairs. Well, I'm not saying whether it's true or not, I'm just repeating what I've heard, but... Well, it gave the king the perfect excuse, didn't it, to get rid of her? Jumped up little tart, she deserved everything she got. After all, we all know what the golden rule is in this place. Don't upset the king.
The king was merciful in his way. They were going to use a sword instead of an axe. It's quicker. There's kindness. They even sent for an executioner from France.
Whatever they said about her, she went to her death bravely.
of God. Pray for me. Lord Jesus, receive my soul.
You'd have thought with Anne Boleyn out the way that it would have been easier for Mary, but it wasn't. Of course, she didn't make it easy for herself. She still thought that she was the king's rightful heir. And that meant that all those people who didn't believe in the new church saw her as a figurehead for their rebellion.
My own daughter, Cromwell. She defies me. Tell me she still hears Mass. While she goes on with this delusion, we'll have every rebel and traitor putting her up as the queen. Better sort it out. Otherwise, there will be consequences. Consequences, Cromwell. Consequences? Good blade. Painful consequences. And I don't exclude you from that. Not at all. I'm sure you get my drift. Do you get my drift?
My dearest father and sovereign lord, I most humbly prostrate myself before your noble feet, your most obedient subject and humble child, who have committed her soul only to God, and her body to be ordered in this world as it shall stand in your pleasure, I do, and will submit me in all things to your goodness and pleasure.
I will submit me in all things, except the thing he wanted most. She wouldn't say she was a bastard. She was a princess, the king's truly begotten daughter.
By your own folly and fantasy, show your contempt for God, for your father and his laws.
I am here to express the king's severe displeasure at your continued obstinacy towards him, your disobedience of his laws, such gross disobedience, that the king begins to think you are no longer his daughter, but some monster of nature. However, the king is prepared to show you mercy and to give you one last chance. For myself, I cannot understand why the king is so lenient towards you, so tolerant. If you were my daughter, do you know what I'd do to you? Do you? I would knock your head against that wall until it became as soft as a baked apple.
You can't talk to her like that.
Do you know who you're talking to? Do you know what we can do to you? Anyway.
The king, in his infinite tolerance, is prepared to show you mercy. On condition that you recognize him as your sovereign.
Yes, of course.
You will recognize him as your sovereign, and you will submit to his laws. In particular, you will acknowledge the king as the supreme head of the church.
I can't do that!
You will utterly refuse that the Bishop of Rome has any authority in this kingdom.
No!
And you will acknowledge that your mother's marriage to the king
that.
Was by God's law and man's law, incestuous and unlawful.
No, I can't you do that!
You will sign the articles to
no.
that effect.
No!
You will sign the articles to that effect.
No, I can't do that.
You will sign. For if you do not, the consequences will be far worse than you could possibly imagine.
You can't. It would be better. It's a sin. I signed my soul away. I should have let them kill me. It would be better. No. No.
Once Edward was born, everyone was very relieved. You know, everyone was very relieved.
I think maybe people were sort of relieved. Oh, last, a male heir. That's what he wanted. He'd be happy now for a while, won't he?
Even Mary, really, life got easier for her. And she was actually acknowledged to be second in line to the throne by Henry.
The old boy wasn't getting any younger, of course. God knows what sort of pox he had. Oh, well, the wages of sin are paid out equally to the high and the low. And even the greatest kings are slaves to their doctors eventually.
Being so young, the boy king was under the protection of the council. Now, there was a fine group of gentlemen. Somerset, who set himself up as Lord Protector. And then there was Thomas Cranmer, Archbishop of Canterbury, the new Pope, you could say.
At least with the old king, all he wanted to do was get the Pope out of the way. But this was new learning, and everybody had to change. And it was all the old ways, the mass and everything else that we were allowed to keep with the old king, was all swept aside.
The mass is an idolatrous sacrifice.
Steeped in superstition and heresy.
An abomination.
An abomination.
John Dudley, Earl of Warwick, later Lord Northumberland. Ambitious and a Catholic. Oh, no, he used to be. He changed.
From henceforth, the supper of the Lord and the Holy Communion, commonly called the Mass, is to be said in English, to be said aloud and clearly instead of in secret murmurings. Away with the holy water and the holy bread, the palm crosses and the candle mass candles, ashes and creeping to the cross, the foul vapours wafting to the canopy of heaven as if in propitiation of some heathen Baal. Away with the washings, crossings, shriftings, blessings, pilgrimages, purgatory and relics, the lights and bells that go with funerals, and all the other baggage of popery.
People talk about the new learning is what God wants, but how do they know what God wants? I liked the old ways. Salt and oil at christenings, candle mass, and the smell of incense. The sound of the bells ringing out at All Hallows all through the night. So beautiful.
Well, Mary was still sticking by her conscience. She was still a Catholic, and still a thorn in the side of the council.
She's breaking the law. She hears mass publicly with her servants, and people are flocking from miles around to join her.
Well?
Well, we'd better do something.
I don't think we need to do anything at all. If she stays where she is, away from London, she can do no harm. Let her stew.
Make her the focus for every papist rebel in England. You know what's happened in Devon and Cornwall. We must act.
What do you suggest we do? Burn her as a heretic?
Mass is either God or the devil. If it's God, then we should all go to Mass. Well then, if it is the devil, they should be punished without exception, high or low.
It wasn't long ago you were taking Mass.
Sickly little brat. I wouldn't bet much on the little shit surviving. We have a heretic about one bloody cold away from the throne.
Very difficult for us all, m'lady. It's to do with the observance of the law. A law which you and your servants are breaking by taking part in acts of worship which are forbidden by the law. It's contrary to the king's wishes.
But the king is just a child. How can he know his own mind?
That's why he has wise counsellors to advise him.
Oh, you call them wise? The old ways were good enough for them when my father was alive, and now it seems their wisdom is telling them something different. John de Lind.
Nevertheless, m'lady, we've been sent by the council to remind you that the king's law on the observance of Mass applies to everyone.
But I'm only doing what I've done since I was a child. What my father did. And his father before him.
Be that as it may, m'lady. But these practices are forbidden.
Who are you to tell me what is forbidden?
No, no, my lady, it's not us. It's the law. It's the king and the council.
He's right, my lady. It's our duty to inform you that if you do not cease these acts of worship, there will be serious consequences.
The consequences would be far worse if I stopped. The thing that is most important to me, it's the only thing I have to hold on to. I know it to be honest and true, and that is my conscience. I cannot turn it on and off the suit. Not even the council. You talk to me of serious consequences. Well, so be it. I'd rather put my head on the block than betray my God. With you, John Deland. We took the bread together. You must remember.
Yes, I do, m'lady. Very well. But times have changed.
Yes. Times have changed. I must ask you, gentlemen, to excuse me. It is time for me to go to prayer. Would you care to join me?
Suffered me, your poor humble sister and beadswoman, to have used the accustomed mass, which the king, your father and mine, with all his predecessors evermore used.
With all his predecessors evermore used. Wherein also I have been brought up from my youth, and thereto my conscience doth not only bind.
Conscience! Pox on her bloody conscience.
My conscience doth not only bind me, which by no means will suffer me to think one thing and do another, but the promise made to the emperor by way of assurance.
And just who does this emperor think he is? The King of England?
No, any more than you are.
We have heretics coming from miles around to hear Mass with her. They call her Your Grace. Did you know that? We are facing open rebellion.
It's a few poor misguided people.
It's a plot. And if we let it go any longer, we will make her a focus for every rebel, heretic and traitor in the country.
What are we to do? We imprison a priest. Another takes his place. Brave men.
The time for playing games is over. We must root this out. Destroy it. We must go right to the heart of the matter. The princess must be made to see the danger that she's in. Not very good for her health. This kind of thing can bring on a sudden decline. Anything could happen. Her heart might not survive the strain. or the food. She's in fragile health. She's prey to sickness. Everyone knows if you're weak, you eat something that disagrees with you, it can be enough to push you over into an irreversible downward spiral.
I could pray, couldn't I? It's quite possible they will succeed. We'll find some way of getting rid of me. Why should I survive? I think it would be easier for me if I died. I sometimes think that would be such a release. How sweet could that be?
Don't talk like that.
Feeling, oh, so weak in my body. You know how it is with predators. They find the weakest one, and then they encircle it, and they run it to ground, and it cannot be saved. And that's how it is with me. I cannot be saved. I will be encircled and run to ground.
You're tired. You'll feel better later.
I could easily go under, and they would get exactly what they want. They would take down all vestige of the old ways, all the things that I love. They will all disappear. There's no one to save me.
Your grace, God will protect you. What are you doing?
I'm baking apples for Her Grace. You know she likes baked apples because of her teeth. I just thought that it might cheer her up.
Why cloves?
It's for the flavour. She's always liked cloves for flavour.
Where did you get them?
From Her Grace's garden.
You didn't go further afield?
No, my lady.
And what's this?
Just some basil.
Are you sure?
Brought me here to instruct me in the law. It is a very strange law these days. My servants are threatened. My own person is threatened. Is this a good example of how the law works?
My lady, if you have any proof of these allegations, please tell me. I promise we will act immediately.
To observe the law. My father's law. How many of you are here today because of my father? How many of you swore on the book to observe his settlement? Now he is dead, you can contradict him. You wouldn't have dared while he was living.
Well, times have changed, my lady.
Oh yes, times have changed. I barely recognize my own country, so changed it is.
place where the treasures of the church are burned or stolen. The saints are mocked. You may no longer hear confession, nor take the bread, because that is a crime. And the real crime is to forbid these things to true believers.
This is heresy.
God knows who the heretics are.
Yes, my lady. He does.
You can take everything. You can take everything on earth that I own. You can take my birthright. You can take my title. For God knows what my rightful title is. Take my soul. You cannot take my God. I die first. My life is pain. Give this to the king. Tell him he is my own dear brother, and I will obey him in everything. Except that which takes away my soul.
We've come to hear Mass, Your Grace.
Poor Mary. Nothing to hope for while the heretics ruled the roost. But then, hope can spring up in the unlikeliest places.
Useless little arsewipe. All he had to do was stay alive, and he couldn't even do that. She won't do it. She won't do it! Ah! Ah! Should have poisoned the bitch.
lovely fresh cherries.
Well, it was an awful atmosphere in London. It was very worrying. We didn't know what was happening. There's all these rumours going around as to whether the king was dead or not. I mean, we didn't know whether he was. We knew he'd been ill. And then, of course, light begins to dawn. We realise, of course, that it's Northumberland that's behind all this. He wants to keep power, so he's going to put Lady Jane on the throne, his daughter-in-law.
Long live the Queen! Long live the Queen!
It's ridiculous. Who is this person? It should be Mary. We all know Mary. We don't know who this is. You can't just put someone, a stranger, on the throne like that.
I mean, Mary was the next in line, wasn't she? She was the king's daughter. She was a Tudor. She was going to be queen, as far as we were concerned.
When I first heard of the Lady Jane Grey business and what Northumberland was planning, if I'd had my dagger and he'd come anywhere near me, I mean, what was he trying to achieve? Did he really think that he could get away with it? He was trying to destroy the royal line of England. We all knew that Mary was the rightful queen.
Yeah, it's true, I was one of Northumberland's men, me and 3,000 others. And we were all told to muster up at Tothill Fields to bring in the Lady Mary. And as we set off out of London, and there was a strange feeling in the air. When people come out to look at us, they weren't wishing us Godspeed. They were sort of staring at us blankly, as if, you know, wondering what we were doing, questioning what we were doing, and made us feel a bit uncomfortable, to be honest with you.
Well, there were many important gentlemen who were coming to support the Queen. Sir John Morden, Sir Henry Bedingfield, and many other gentlemen. But it wasn't just them, you see. There were people from all over the countryside, the common people, who were there ready to fight, willing to support the Queen. And we were there shouting, "God save the Queen!" And we all knew which queen that was.
People who were meant to be joining us never turned up. People who'd sworn to be loyal to Northumberland and to the cause disappeared. And people that were meant to be taking her into custody were going over to her side instead, begging her for pardon. Ah, it's hopeless.
Heard that there's going to be a proclamation out at the Cross of Cheek. And I joined this flood of people. There were people everywhere, just going down, just to see what was going on.
Loyal subjects, the Crown of England, I can announce that Princess Mary is now, on this day, Queen of England!
Hey! Long live the Queen! Long live the Queen!
When I think about the miracle that's happened, I feel so humble. It seems that everything in my life, everything I've suffered, they've just been a preparation for this moment. I can see now what it was you were doing. It was a test of my strength. I must ask you to forgive me for doubting you. It's very clear to me. I must do what you want. You've put your trust in me, and I will not let you down.
I shall make England clean again and bright.
Northumberland got arrested. Well, he was due for the chop and he got it.
Well, Mary was lenient with the others, but she couldn't be for him. I heard that he even became a Catholic again to try and save his skin. But that didn't save him. Nor should it have done.
I believe in one God, Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and of all things visible and invisible, and in one Lord, Jesus Christ.
I mean, it was a really nice day for a chopping, you know. We saw him get chopped in the morning, then went down to the Orgade for a picnic in the afternoon. Made it a really nice day out.
One baptism for the remission of sin. I look to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. I have deserved 1,000 deaths.
Queen Mary is restored as the rightful heir of Henry, the late king. All laws banning the hearing of Mass are repealed. The Holy Father in Rome is restored as the rightful head of the Church in England. It is now illegal to attend the so-called Protestant service. The laws allowing priests to marry are repealed.
When that new learning came in, our old way was wrong. That was the devil. So we worship in the new way.
Guardian!
And now that's wrong. And so now we're back to worshipping in the old way.
It's all very confusing if you ask me. I mean, to be honest with you, it doesn't make a lot of difference to the likes of me. We're just trying to survive. Make a living, you know.
We just did what we were told. It was easier that way. We don't want to get into any trouble. There's enough trouble as it is.
Come back!
All the powerful people, of course, they change over again, don't they? But do they do it for a love of God, or do they do it to keep their power?
mind you. Didn't include them giving back all the lands they'd stolen from the church. They held on to those. And of course there was the priests. I mean, now they become Catholic again, they had to give up their wives. Didn't stop them paying their ex-wives a little visit now and again.
We know where you've been!
Well, I think she thought that she'd just be able to change everything back to the way it was. Tear it all away and go back to the old ways, but it wasn't going to be that easy, you know.
I think everybody would have been happy to go back to the old ways with the church. It was a real shame. What really changed everything, she married the Spaniard. If she hadn't have married that Spaniard, everything would have probably been okay.
And of course the council wanted her to marry that English fella, what was his name, Courtney. Yeah, nice lad, but she wasn't having any of that.
I find it very offensive you should wish to marry me to a subject. I'll decide who I'll marry. I find this interference very strange. Most unwelcome.
Not to interfere, Your Grace, but to give you guidance.
I require no guidance from you. I take my guidance from God. Only I can decide who's going to be my husband. If you try and force me against my will, I should be dead within 3 months. That would hardly suit your purpose. I shall ask God and his wisdom to guide me in my choice. His decision will be final.
We were all terribly worried about getting involved with a Spaniard, dragging us off into some foreign war and all sorts of nonsense, taking all our money. We weren't happy about it.
Now, Reynard, he was a wily character. He was the ambassador to the Holy Roman Empire, and he was trying to convince her to marry Philip. Well, you know, she was the daughter of Spain. Her mother was Spanish, so why wouldn't she like the idea?
But a young prince will want a young bride. I am too old.
No. No. Your Grace, age is no barrier in this. Some people, however young, lack spirit and seem old, whereas a more mature person may have the spirit of the young and the beautiful. Now, Prince Philip may be young, but he has the wisdom, the experience, the knowledge of a much older man. He has been married before. He has a son of 7 years. And of course, he sees this as a great opportunity.
He does?
Not only would this be a wonderful alliance between England and Spain, but also personally. He views this prospect with a great excitement.
She was very indecisive about that, and eventually, after all the pressure, she did give in, and she wrote a letter to the council saying that she wasn't going to marry Philip.
They win. They win, of course they win.
You must not give up. You must keep fighting. Please think about it.
I have thought about it. I hadn't thought about anything else. I can't bear it.
Don't send it. If you do, it'll all be over.
That's what I want. An end to it. It's a stupid, foolish idea. I should marry Courtney or whoever they want. So stupid to think that I can make it work.
What's happened? You'd made up your mind. Remember what Ambassador Reyna said.
Reyna says what he needs to say to get what he wants.
And so do your parliament. But what about you? This isn't about politics for you. Isn't marriage about the heart?
The heart? What do I know about the heart? You know more than anyone that I'm innocent of all this. It has passed me by.
Until now. Maybe now is your chance. You know, they say he's very handsome.
You shouldn't say these things.
But what if Reyna is right? It is the perfect match. And the perfect union between England and Spain. And you would have an heir.
It's impossible. It's impossible. But if only it could be true.
God gave you your throne. Surely he'll give you a boy.
De lo último que necesitamos hablar es de su matrimonio. ¿Ha estado pensando sobre ello?
Sí, dime más.
Según de los planes de su padre, es definitivamente un buen casamiento. Inglaterra sería un valioso aliado contra Francia. Y una heredera ayudaría a mantener Inglaterra como un país católico.
Sí, sí, sí. ¿Y qué edad tiene la María?
Tiene 37.
Pues exactamente una chica. De mona, me dicen que no tiene mucho.
Es una mujer muy sincera, honesta y muy devota.
Bueno.
Su padre está muy interesado de organizar este casamiento.
Sí, pero no será mi padre que tendrá que acostarse con ella.
Según dice que es muy divertida. Y su carácter la hace muy atractiva. Y recuerde el premio que aporta este matrimonio. Inglaterra.
La Inglaterra. A mí me da igual la Inglaterra. Está llena de lluvia y de piratas borrachos. Pero, ¿qué hacer ahora?
Un intercambio de regalos será organizado.
Vale.
It seemed impossible you would be queen, but it happened. And that England would be rid of heresy, but that happened. And this will happen, because God wants it.
It is what he would want. Philip, I almost feel like I know him already. Does that sound ridiculous?
Not at all.
Oh, this isn't me.
What do you mean?
Happiness. It's strange to me. I never thought I would be happy. That's for other people. Now I'm almost afraid to be happy.
Bloody Spain!
It will happen.
Seek no harm to the Queen. We bow down to
Sir Thomas Wyatt. He was a gentleman. And he was dead set against her marrying a Spaniard.
She has been deceived by the Spaniard, whose only purpose is to turn all Englishmen into his slaves. She no longer knows her own mind, nor the better...
He didn't like the thought of us losing our country. That England belonged to us, not to the Spaniards. I don't think he had a very valid point.
So he can be safe from the evil Spaniard.
Well, we heard that Wyatt had reached Southwark, and he had about 3,000 men with him. Well, it was a question of whether London would join him, or whether they'd stay loyal to the Queen.
There was pandemonium in the city. They ordered that the gates were shut. Everyone went and got arms, whatever they could pick up and carry.
When we heard the rebel army were making their approach that night, the whole palace was thrown into chaos.
I was part of Our Grace's bodyguard. And that night, we were told to muster in her chamber. As we did so, I noticed the members of her council huddled in corners, muttering, hedging their bets as to which would be the winning side.
And in the middle of all this, Mary was calm and brave. She could have escaped.
And we all of us took strength from her that night. That was the night she really gained my respect.
And then we heard that the Queen was going to make a speech at Guildhall. So we all went down there. And there were hundreds of people there.
By the time I got there was a large crowd and I was right at the back. I could hear the Queen speaking, but I couldn't see her, being such a small lady. But one thing I never forget were the words that she used.
Will you defend me against these traitors and these rebels? For I do say to you now that I have a mind to stay, live and die with you.
And Mary just talked to us straight. She said if we went against the rebels, she'd be there with us, up the front. And if we died, then she'd be there dying with us as well.
I cannot tell how naturally a mother doth love her child, for I was never mother to any.
She said, like, we were her children, and she was our mother, not that she had children of her own, and that she would protect us and stand by us. If we supported her, she was willing to die for us.
I started thinking of my wife and kiddies. And it got to me and, well, I shed a tear.
If we stand together, I know we shall prevail. And then we can live nobly, honourably, and in freedom, in the one true faith.
Rebellion was crushed. Suddenly there were gibbets all over London and Kent.
There was a real sense of an atmosphere that I will not put up with anybody trying to walk over me anymore. That's it. I've had enough. Don't walk over me, otherwise this is what's going to happen. I've had enough of you.
She was known, if you like, for her leniency, but after that rebellion, something changed and she'd become harder.
What a wonderful day it was. There was music, there was dancing, there was more food than you can ever imagine.
Banqueting table. Oh, that was laden down with the most luxurious food I've ever seen.
That spoke in French, English, Latin. They listed all the countries that Mary and Philip ruled over. Jerusalem, Brabant, Sicily. Sounded like the whole world to me. Mary looked beautiful. She had a white dress. It was lined with gold. Her wedding band was gold too. Very simple. Mary's idea. She said it was how maids were married of old. He was very handsome, despite being a Spaniard. And they looked very happy.
María también estaba muy elegante, ella un vestido muy bonito, pero en fin, ya se sabe lo que se dice, ¿no? Que la mona, aunque se viste de seda, en mona se queda.
No cabe duda de que ella es una santa, con un corazón enorme. Pero bueno, no creo que tuviera otra elección.
Venga, no te escondas.
Venga.
Vieni qui, princesita.
Sabes que sou eu. I don't know what to do.
Jenny's mother?
Si.
It's both. Jenny's a coffee lady. Coffee's a lady.
We heard that she was going to have a baby.
And it all seemed to fit so well. After she'd faced down a rebellion, she'd now have an heir, she'd be able to continue the Catholic faith.
You to forgive me. It seems that I am always doubting you. And I know you have a plan for me. You have given me a sign.
We were all so excited at the news. Noble ladies came to court to be with Mary. And we were told the happy event would be in May.
But May came, and there was no baby. May turned to June, and still no sign of a child.
Oh, I'm sure I felt it move.
By July, it was just another mystery, another sadness.
How could a pregnancy go on for 11 months? It's like the pregnancy had just carried on and on, and it just wasn't possible. It's like, well, apparently she looked pregnant, but there was no baby.
Así que poco a poco se, bueno, se fue vaciando. Los aposentos, se fueron las cortesanas, se fueron las nobles, se llevaron la cuna, se quedó todo como un vacío. En fin, fue una historia muy, muy extraña, unos meses muy tensos, pero sobre todo muy, muy triste.
Blame the doctors. They should have told her. I expect they were scared. Mary was too old.
too old.
Sí, sí, habían rumores. Habían rumores de que... había tenido un chiquillo con... de que finalmente había tenido el chiquillo, pero que había salido con dos cabezas. Había otro rumor que decía que incluso tenía cara... cara de mono.
Baby? More like a bad case of the wind.
Entonces, ¿no, niño?
Todo eso es una farsa. Lo he intentado. He intentado vivir aquí. Yo mismo he intentado beber cerveza inglesa.
¿Y cómo es?
Sabe mejor. Me queda más nada hacer aquí.
The thing has just got worse after that. We had a terrible summer. The summer storms were the worst I can remember. The harvest failed, and the same thing happened for the next two summers, so there was very little food about, you know, with three harvests failing.
You've got to wonder why, and what most people said was it was God taking it out on Queen Mary, marrying the Spaniard.
Well, to cap it all, we lost Calais to the French. And Mary took that very badly. Well, we all took it very badly.
It's a kind of like I told you so, if you married him, look what you've done. Look what God's doing to us. Don't you see what you've done?
It was around that time that the burning started. It was so out of character. I don't think that she was cruel like that, but she had to have something to blame. All the things that had gone wrong in her life. So she blamed the new learning.
It is my fault. Wrong in thinking of my own happiness. I put myself before my task. You put your faith in me, but I forgot to do what it is you want. I can feel your anger. It is in your silence. I will prove myself worthy. I shall clean this country of the curse of heresy.
I knew this man called John Miller. Nice, gentle man. Used to meet you on the street and say hello. And then suddenly they singled him out. Said he was in league with the devil.
Even now it's not too late. Accept the bread and wine as the body and blood of Christ.
No, I can't. I can't sign your declaration. I have my faith. I have to follow my faith, whatever the danger.
Do you realize the trouble that you're in? You must accept the Mass.
I don't recognize your Mass. Your Mass is heresy.
Oh, please just sign it. Please, John, please don't leave me. Just give them what they want, please. Please, just give them what they want.
It will be wrong.
I knew John Miller, did he was a nice man. Easy going, do anything for anyone.
Why did you have to be so cruel? Why not just let God punish them? So brave. I mean, I know they were heretics, but they seemed to go willingly to their death.
If God's kind, would he mind how we worship him? Would it really matter to him? I don't think it would. Not the God that I believe.
Have I pleased you?
The burnies didn't do any good. The more people they burn, the more stubborn they seem to get. If she'd have had an heir, a boy, then England would have stayed Catholic. We wouldn't have gone to war with Spain. We'd have been part of Spain.
El sentimiento principal que me queda es el de una oportunidad perdida y pena. Pena por María, pero también por los dos países, ¿no?
She was always true to her conscience, which meant she wasn't wily enough or ambitious enough to succeed. She became a victim, if you like. She was just hated by everybody.
We have a new queen. She's young, she's strong, she's beautiful, and she's a Protestant. All the things that Mary wasn't. But Elizabeth the heroine, Mary the villain.
Was she any crueler than, well, certainly not crueler than her father.
She was the Spaniard's whore who bore him a monkey dead. The act of God was very odd, and so all England said. Mary, Mary, bloody Mary, kill a queen of England.